Lord God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, we choose Gilbert Marcos, our brother, for the order of the priesthood. My dear brothers and sisters, because this our brother, who is your relative and friend, is now to be advanced to the order of priests. Consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church to which he is about to be raised. It is true that God has made his entire body people a royal priesthood in Christ. Nevertheless, our great priest himself, Jesus Christ, chose certain disciples to carry out publicly in his name and on behalf of mankind a priestly office in the church. For Christ was sent by the Father, and he in turn sent the apostles into the world. So that through them and their successors, the bishops, he might continue to exercise his office of teacher, priest, and share. Indeed, priests are established core workers of the order of bishops, with whom they are joined in the priestly office, and with whom they are called to the service of the people of God. After the church deliberation, this outbreak is now the ordained of the priesthood in the order of the presbyter, so as to serve Christ the teacher, priest, and shepherd, by whose ministry his body, that is the church, is filled and grows into the people of God, a holy temple. In being configured to Christ, the eternal high priest, and joined the priesthood of the bishops, he will be consecrated as a true priest of the new testament, to preach the gospel, to shepherd God's people, and to celebrate our second liturgy, especially the Lord's sacrifice. Now, my dear Deacon Gilbert, you are to be raised in the order of the priesthood. For your part, you will exercise the second duty of teaching in the name of Christ's teacher, in part of everyone the word of God, which you have received in joy, meditating on the law of the Lord, so that you believe what you believe, and you preach, and you teach what you believe, and that you practice what you teach. In this way, let what you teach be nourishment for the people of God. Let the holiness of your life be a delightful fragrance to Christ's death to you, so that by word and example, you will give up the house in his God's church. Likewise, you will exercise in Christ the office of sanctifying. For by your ministry, the spiritual sacrifice of the faithful will be made perfect, being united to the sacrifice of Christ, which will be offered to your hands in an unblending way for the altar, in union with the faithful, in the celebration of the sacraments. Understand therefore what you do, and imitate what you serve, as a celebrant of the mystery of the Lord's death and resurrection. Strive to put to death whatever in your members is sinful, and to walk in the newness of life. Remember, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. Do you resolve, with the help of the Holy Spirit, to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyterian rank as a worthy fellow worker in the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the public faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate thankfully and reverently in accord with the Church's tradition. The mystery of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to improve with us, to improve with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command you pray without ceasing?
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely every day with Christ, the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God. I do.
May God, who has begun a good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Dear people, let us pray that God, the Almighty Father, who pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on this servant, whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
Let us kneel.
Thank you.